In this video, we're going to learn how to use aggregation window functions in ClickHouse. So let's launch ClickHouse local, and then we're going to describe the salaries view that I created earlier. And you can see it comes back. We've got a team, we've got a player, we've got a position and a salary. Let's have a look at some of the data based on that view. So you can see it comes back. We've got a bunch of Premier League teams, their players, the position that the player plays, and then the various salaries that they have. Okay, so our first query is going to return the player, the team, the position, the player's salary, and then we're going to compute a window function that is the max salary over, and then it's going to be partitioned by the position. So we're finding the maximum salary for the given position, and then we'll compute the difference from the individual player's salary to that maximum salary. So you can see it comes back. So the person with the biggest difference from their salary to the maximum for that position is Gavin Kilkenny. So his salary is £1,500 a week, and the maximum for the position, which is M, so midfield, is £400,000. So you can see it's a massive, massive gap. We can then tweak that query. So we can say we're going to use a different partition. So this time we'll partition it by the team. So we're going to be comparing an individual player to the maximum for their team. And if we run that query again, you can see we get back a different set of results. So this time Oscar Bob is the top result. So his salary is £8,000, and the maximum for a Manchester City player is 400,000. And you can see the top seven or so are all Manchester City players. But then if we come down to position eight, we can see we've got Shawright from Manchester United. He's earning 5,000, and the maximum for them is 350,000. And then if we come down a couple more rows, we can see Kelleher for Liverpool earns 10,000, and the maximum for Liverpool is 350,000. So a gap of 340,000. Let's write another query. So we're going to get the player, the team, and the salary. And then we're going to compute the average salary as a window function partitioned by the team. And then we'll compute the difference from an individual player to that average. And then we're going to also compute as a window function the median, again partitioned by team. And again, we'll compute the difference. Now, the reason for doing average and median is that the average can be skewed by very high values or very low values, whereas the median is going to find the middle salary. And then let's have a look at the results. So we can see Oscar Bob is at the top again. So he's 151,600 away from the average salary for Manchester City. And the median salary is only just a few pounds higher. So their median and average are almost the same. And Oscar Bob is equally far away from both of them. But if we look down a little bit, the Manchester United players are much closer to the median than they are to the average. The average is a lot higher than the median salary being paid. So that kind of implies to us there are some players earning like a lot of money in the Manchester United team. Now in this query, since we're using the same over clause multiple times, we can pull that out into a named window clause. So we'll call it team partition, and then we can go back in for the median and change the over to be over team partition, and do exactly the same for the average, so average salary over team partition as well. And then we get back, it's going to be exactly the same result, so nothing different here. Let's now have a look at salary distribution across a team and position. So we're going to create ourselves a CTE called salary dist. We'll get the player, the team, the position, and the salary. And then we're going to use the group array function on salary. So it's going to get us an array of all the salaries based on the window function partition key, which in this case, we're going to do team and position. So it's going to get us the salaries for an individual player by their team and position. So if we've got a midfield player playing for Manchester United, it's going to have all the salaries of the midfield players playing for Manchester United, and we'll be able to have a look where they fit along that distribution. And then once we've defined that CTE, we're going to say, I want to query it. We're going to get all the columns except for team. And then we're going to replace the distribution column with a sorted one. So we'll sort it from the lowest salary to the highest one. And we're going to filter it just to get back Arsenal and the position midfield, and we'll format in a vertical style. And you can see it comes back. So down the last place, the lowest paid player, Emil Smith Rowe, and you can see is there 40,000, and you can see he's sort of at the bottom of the array, and all the way over to the right, we can see it's 280,000. If we sort of scroll up a bit, you can kind of see the people sort of sitting in the middle. And if we go right up to the top, we can see there's Kai Havertz at 280,000. We've got Odegaard just below 240,000, Partey 200,000. So we've kind of got three people with very, very high, a few in the middle, and then some much lower earners at the end. If you want to learn more about window functions, check out this video here where we learn how to use the ranking window functions in ClickHouse.